What's going on, everybody? So for those who don't know me, I am Jaren, the founder and owner of this here studio, the Jaren McGirt Studio. In this video, we're going to analyze somebody who is honestly a huge inspiration of mine. He is one of gospel's greatest voices, in my humble opinion, and you all have asked for him time and time again. So I'm super excited to analyze one of my favorite voices, Daryl Coley. And I'm so excited to do this song. He does so many good things with his voice. So y'all, let's cut to the chase. Here's Daryl Coley singing When Sunday Comes.
Sunday comes, my trouble gone, as soon as it gets here, I'll have a new song.
Anybody who starts the song the way he just did, you know it's about to kill. When Sunday comes, he's singing through these consonants so well. And he's taking his time through this part of the song, which is what I love. One of the many things, honestly, I love about this song and about him singing this song. And I love how he just really letting the song billow. You know, and kind of just taking the time, you know, to sing through the song and make sure you hear the words and understand the meaning of the words. You know, so he sung to the consonants, Sunday comes, right there. You know, all that stuff that he's really taking his time. He's not doing a whole lot yet, but you can tell with those few lines that he is very, extremely skilled in what he does.
When Sunday comes, I won't.
Real quick before we get to that good part, I love how he did when Sunday comes. You heard that S at the end of that word, comes. A lot of times you get lazy at the end of words. You kind of say the words at the beginning, but towards the end you get really lazy and kind of forget the last consonants. And I always tell my clients and those who ask about articulation, I prefer clean consonants over hard consonants. This is a prime example of a clean consonant. He didn't say Sunday comes. He just said Sunday comes. It was still clear. I heard every phoneme. I heard every sound that the word has, even that last S consonant. But it wasn't harsh. It wasn't over the top. It was just enough to where we knew he said, when Sunday comes.
I have to cry, no.
Right there. I love how he changed the vowels. Everything was a little more warm at the beginning. When Sunday comes. But he said here, I won't cry, no. So he kind of got a little more spread, a little more bright, almost singing through the molars of his teeth. He also placed the sound a little more forward in his resonance, which causes him to get a little brighter. He's giving us some vocal layers, some things to listen to while he progresses through this song, but still taking his time, making it really sit while he's singing. He's really letting the song sit and marinate while he's singing it this way. It's so good. So if you notice, what I think he did, this is my humble opinion, what I think he did was not push a lot of air. I think people think you have to push a lot of air to hold long notes. It's about using and sustaining the air, not so much pushing the air. He didn't take up like that. He didn't take a lot of breath like that. He just said, I won't cry no more. So he kind of moved his mouth around a little bit to play with the sound. sound, the filter of the sound that we hear. But he didn't tank up. He didn't use a lot of air. He just sustained what he had and probably really engaged his abs and breathing muscles to really help sustain that air right there, because he held it for a long time and he was straight. And then it came vibrato towards the end and it hit that run. So he not only held that note for God knows how long, he had vibrato added to it. Then he hit a run at the end of that long note. Now that is breath control and breath management. He's really using his body to support what he wanted to do with that long more. He just held it out, added vibrato, and then did a run at the end.
Jesus will soon.
Was it mine? Mine? He's getting a little more gritty and a little more bright, a little more aggressive with articulation and his vowel placement.
And all of my heartaches, every burden.
Had a little squall in there. Every burden. Had a little squall, a little growl right there.
All of my misery, all of my crying, every trial, every tribulation.
He's putting the squalls and the growls in, but still being very natural. It's not over the top, it's not overdone. He's making sure the words are heard most of all, because when you minister, you want to make sure you hear the words. Yeah, sound good, and do the rounds, all that kind of stuff. But when it comes to ministry, the words are important. If you don't hear what you're saying, how can you really minister to us in that way? You know, so he's really making sure we hear the words that were written for this song for him to sing. You know, all of my heartache, all of my trials. So he's really making sure that he articulates every single word so we hear it, which is really needed in order to minister a song to an audience. Did you notice how the color changed? So the first one was dark. Second one, a little brighter. Third one, even brighter. Fourth one, even brighter. So you see how I try to change my resonance and my articulation to match his? So the first one had a little more cricoid weight into it. When the second one didn't have any cricoid weight, went a little brighter, a little more speech like, and second one got a little brighter, a little more smiley, and the last one got even more brighter, more forward. Okay, so that's how we did that. So you can really change the filter of the sound, the resonance, to match what you want to do.
So when someday, oh,
he is changing so many things while he is singing this. Like, it's almost hard to keep up with because he's doing so many things in the moment. It's hard to kind of articulate everything. But if you notice, like I said, his resonance is changing. He's changing how he shapes and articulates words. He is changing the notes. He's doing runs. And while he's doing the runs, he's kind of changing the mouth shape to make it kind of glide and have different colors as you come down and come back up. He's doing so many wonderful things in like a given moment. It's so hard to keep up, but it's so great to listen to. Ah, I love it. He's also having a lot of fun with this song. This song, though it's hard, it's also very fun to listen to, you know. love about this is not only that he's having so much fun, but he's really ministering, and that's the most important factor. He's ministering, and he's singing from the heart as to how when Sunday comes, all of our trials, our tribulations, our hurt, our heartache will be over. And this is a figurative Sunday, not the actual day. It could be the actual day of Sunday too, but Sunday is figurative in terms of when morning comes, when that new day comes, maybe it's when we go to heaven. Whatever that means, when Sunday comes, there's so many meanings of when Sunday comes, but honestly, the biggest meaning of when Sunday comes when Jesus rose from the dead. He rose on a Sunday when Sunday comes. So when Jesus rose, he defeated death. He defeated everything that we go through. And so singing a song like this just makes it all the more amazing, because we know in 2021 when Sunday came, what happened. When Sunday came back then, we know what happened to our lives and how our lives changed for the better because he was sacrificed. And I'm glad that he is singing in this way, because the point of the song is when Sunday comes, oh my God, it's gonna be over. We thank God that it's over, you know? So I love that he's really singing it in this way, and it's really ministering. He's just singing from the heart. This is how he sings. This is how he worships. I love it. I love it. To say from when he did the comes, that long note when he comes back in before the choir comes in to just behold his face part. If you notice, once again, he didn't tank up. He didn't swallow a lot of air and try to push through. He's not pushing a lot of air as he sings this stuff. You simply cannot push a lot of air while trying to sing songs like this, trying to sing this high energy tessitura range type stuff. You can't really push a lot of air simply because it's going to probably hinder you more than help you if you push too much air. People think air equals loud. No. Air does not equal loud. Air is not simultaneous to loud. And so you don't need a lot of air to be loud. Think about it. Go to your favorite concert, favorite sporting event, and your favorite artist come out with an encore, or your favorite team scores when you touchdown basket, whatever. So when that stuff happens, you just start screaming, right? Just, ah, you know, you start screaming. You don't think, oh yeah, I gotta tank up and get the air in my lungs to scream and be loud. No, you just start screaming. You just start going hard, and it's loud, it's boisterous, it's exciting. Same thing with singing. You don't have to push a lot of air or use a lot of air or need a lot of air to be loud and high, whatever the case may be. It's about managing the air that you have and understanding that it's other parts that go into singing besides air. He is a prime example of just that. He's not pushing a lot of air. He's using the air as best as he can, coasting on that air, and using other parts of his vocal apparatus to really sing and minister the song the way he is with this video. Say this, Tri-City Singers, one of the best choirs, best gospel choirs ever, in my opinion. And I think a lot of people agree with me with that. They are one of the best choirs and groups today. They are amazing. I've always loved how polished and clean and cohesive they sound. So let's give a nod to the Tri-City Singers under the direction of Mr. Donald Lawrence. And I remember when this album came out, Bible Stories. This song is from Bible Stories by Donald Lawrence and the Tri-City Singers. I remember when this album came out, I was pretty young. I think I was like a single digit age for sure. But you know, I remember there's a strange in town, he's giving sight to the blind. Peter, don't be afraid. Remember that one? Oh my gosh, I was there. Oh my gosh, all these songs I grew up knowing, and they kind of shaped me musically, and how Donald used music in this way to tell us Bible stories. I mean, like him, Twiggy Clark, Richard Smallwood, they really write scripture. They write scripture. It ain't like no oohs and ahs, no Jesus I love you. No, they write the word. A lot of the scriptures that I've learned and memorized came through Donald Lawrence, came through Twiggy Clark, came through Richard Smallwood. I learned these scriptures from them. And so I think it's so amazing how they can make these scriptures sound so much more more alive through how they orchestrate it, how they compose it in music. It's amazing. So a nod to Donna Lawrence as well. Absolutely.
Hey, hey, hey. Awesome. You see, on Friday, they took him and they stretched him high. Whoa. And stretched him wide.
About this part is that he's really telling the story of when Sunday comes. Like I said before, it's about when Jesus rose from the dead on Sunday morning. So right here, he's telling us the whole timeline, when Friday happened, when Saturday happened, when Sunday happened, and what happened each of those days. And he's really making sure we understand the point of this song. I know a lot of people say, I wish I could ad-lib more in church, this, that, and the third. I think a lot of times people miss ad-libbing for thinking I gotta do acrobatics. Mm-mm. It's not always about that. It's about driving the point of the song home, in my opinion. When I have my clients ask me about ad-libbing, especially in church and kind of exhorting and things like that, I tell them that the point of ad-libbing, in my opinion, is to drive home the point of the song. So here during this vamp, he's telling us the actual point, the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, which is part of the good news. He's telling us about Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, when Sunday comes, right? So in church, I typically get a lot of the songs that are heavy on ad-libs, either like super churchy ad-libs or like super hard ballads. I never get anything else besides those two. It's either the super churchy with a whole bunch of ad-libs like, oh, how precious, because of the blood. Those types of songs. I get those songs, or I get songs like, you know, I don't know, like a super hard ballad, like a Celine Dion gospel song. I don't know, something like that. But when I get those super churchy ad-libby songs, I really take the time to write down ad-libs. I take the time to think about and pray about what I'm going to say. So then if I can figure nothing else, I have a whole list of things I can talk about. I look up scriptures, think about scriptures that can relate to the song. I think about hymns that can relate to the song. Re-say those hymns. Re-say those scriptures. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Don't try to reinvent the wheel. Just keep the wheel turning. There's enough content, enough words, and enough inspiration out there. Just keep that wheel turning. Don't reinvent it. Don't try to say new stuff if you don't have new stuff to say. And then we get up on stage and the Lord ministers and you feel like I got something else to say. You got a platform to say it on. You got a trampoline to jump off of. But if all else fails, you still have an articulated plan as to what you want to say when you ad-lib and when you improv. And that's what he's doing here. He's really ad-libbing in a way where we understand the point of the song. I love that.
They wouldn't let anybody come to the grave, but I had something going on the inside.
Oh, son.
You see, I heard that the Lord went to hell and preached the revival.
Right here, he's really telling us about when Sunday comes, what's going to happen when Sunday comes. I'm going to shout my troubles over. I'm going to be happy when Sunday comes. And vocally, he got a little higher now because the choir inverted a little bit. So now he kind of brought his vocal line a little bit higher to go with the choir so that he could keep up with the tessitura and the intensity that the choir has now brought to the song. Vanessa Armstrong are the two of the best sliders in the game. Like, I love those slides. I don't think I do them well, but I feel like they do them so well. He just did it right there. He slid up, body modulated up a little bit, then came back in with more things to say. So he really understands how the song goes. I'm sure they rehearsed a few times, or maybe not, who knows. But he slid up right there with that modulation and came right back in with more things to say.
I'm
not afraid.
that this song is not easy to sing. He's making it look easy, but this song is not easy to sing. This song is, I think, like 7 minutes long. 7 minutes of this. This song is not easy to sing. And he's making it look effortless. Like, it's like, oh, it's nothing. Oh, meanwhile, I'm like, woo. People have asked me to sing this song, and I would love to sing this song somewhere. I just haven't had the opportunity to sing it anywhere, honestly. My uncle in particular asks me every time he sees me to sing when Sunday comes. And one day, I'm going to sing it one day. Maybe somewhere, if I got an opportunity, or somebody wants to sing it. But see, a lot of people don't sing this stuff no more. A lot of people want to sing the new stuff. They don't want to sing this old, good stuff. They want to sing this newer stuff. So, you know, I don't know if I'll be able to sing this song ever. for real, honestly. Have lost my marbles in the spirit had I been sitting there in the audience when that happened. Even being 7, 8 years old, I don't care how old I was. If I would have heard him sing that song like that, or sing that song, if I was an adult hearing that song, I would have been rolling on the carpet, rolling up and down the choir stand, rolling somewhere. And it's because I know what Sunday means to me. I know what his resurrection means to me. So tell me what you heard him do. Drop it in the comments below and let's talk about it for a second. Now, if you haven't already, which I hope you have, click subscribe down below and click the alert button next to it so you know when the next video was posted. Remember to be vocally bold, creative, and aware, but most of all, be vocally you. All right, y'all. I see y'all real soon.